Of course, we're all handling social distancing a little bit differently. And for some, it's a welcome break. For others, it's downright brutal. As Clayton Sandell shows us, it's no different for residents of the Denver Zoo.
At the Denver Zoo, the flamingos are on the loose, getting a little exercise on pathways that used to be crowded with people.
We just added more flamingos and have just been venturing further and further.
With the zoo closed thanks to coronavirus, keepers say some animals miss those crowds.
This is our emu.
Take Ralph.
We've definitely noticed that anytime anyone walks by, he's right at the front here and checking us out.
Yuri is normally shy for a tiger.
He's very good. Oh, there he is, actually right there.
But lately, he's showing more of his stripes.
He's been a little bit more exploratory in his environment. He's started to try and explore this catwalk above your head.
The giraffes are rubbernecking more than usual.
We're getting a lot of stares.
Specifically from Dobby. He is very people-oriented.
And for Tundra the grizzly, the zoo even smells different.
They can smell miles and miles away, but without anybody here, she doesn't have that much new stuff to smell.
The guest may be gone, but caring for nearly 3,000 animals is nonstop.
We have a lot of essential staff, from our animal care to our grounds and horticulture maintenance staff. A lot of people are doing a lot of work every day, 7 days a week.
After lions and tigers tested positive for COVID-19 at a New York zoo, everyone here is on guard.
We're taking additional precautions with keepers that work with species that might be able to contract the virus.
He's really smart, really sweet.
With no crowds, Cindy Kasaboon and her fellow zookeepers have started spending lunchtime with some lonely orangutans.
So this is Irina. She's probably the goofiest orangutan I've ever worked with. She's probably the one that misses the people the most. She just loves to play with people.
The public still hasn't seen two-month-old rhino Juna in person, but keepers say there's an upside.
Helping her get acclimated, it's a lot faster not having hundreds and hundreds of people screaming and excited, and all of those things can be potential added stressors.
The elephants haven't forgotten the crowds either.
Especially Chuck, he definitely has a knack for connecting with guests.
But other beasts don't seem to be bothered.
The kangaroos don't seem to care at all.
They may have noticed the difference, but it doesn't really seem to be affecting their behavior very much.
How weird is it to see this place completely empty?
It's been a little strange.
The zoo is hoping that paying customers can come back soon. Animal care is costing about $1 million a month, but until the pandemic is over, the zoo is, well, for the birds. Clayton Sandell, ABC News, Denver.
For the birds, indeed.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.